Epoxy is everywhere, and epoxy is part of this process. I'm covered in epoxy, I have it in my hair, and I'm pretty sure I can't quite open this eye all the way because of epoxy.
Previously on Sailing Adrift, we put another wall up, introduced our first ever segment of Road Snacks, enjoyed 4th of July with the family, and then coerced them into helping us out.
We have been planning on finishing the aft cabin to the point where we were ready to move on to the forward part of the boat for a long time. And we'd like to get this stuff done so we get the boat back in the water. Well, this is enough of a list to get us started. It's going to be a long, long list of little jobs. We'll see how far we can get. But we're gonna stop at the tire and work our way down. I'm sure we'll have to skip a few things because a lot of this is dependent on the other person and where they're at. Kelly! She was here and now she's gone.
It's just like all of a sudden the plum tree has plums.
I've been dodging them for weeks. Kelly, this is a daunting list of things, and it's not even complete because there's a bunch of other shit to do.
Clearly.
Yeah, it says so right there.
Okay, so this is a divide and conquer list, not a...
Kind of. I mean, I think we're going to have to go back and forth.
Okay, but you've designed it so that we're not climbing over the top of each other because I hate that.
I am trying to make it that way. I am well aware of the fact you don't like to be in the same room as me, so I'm going to try to accommodate that for you.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
What a guy.
All right, so let's get after it.
Okay.
I'm going to start. You make yourself busy.
All right.
You know, drink your coffee.
Thanks.
And be a chick. I'm going to go fare the aft cabin.
Mm.
Should we do a epic high five?
Yeah.
All right. Now, here's the keys to a good high five.
Okay.
You got to maintain eye contact and still get good contact with the high five. And here's the thing that I've noticed.
What?
A lot of people like to stop it when at impact.
Uh-huh.
But real, true high fivers...
High five through the hand.
You go through the hand.
Yeah.
If you're going to get a high five, you got to like get it up there and really smack.
So like over your head.
Yeah, it's called a high five.
Yeah,
and
but...
you're already a low five too. So you got to get it up there. Are you ready? Are you ready to try this? It's like whap. I mean, if our hands don't bleed a little bit, we didn't do it right.
Okay. Ow,
got it. That wasn't even a good one. We got to do it again. Ready?
I need some recovery time.
It's a...
Thanks. Yeah. Now I'm like anticipating the hurt.
Well, you can tell. You not only did you just not freeze, you recoiled as the hand came in.
Why does it hurt so much?
Do you want to switch hands?
No, I don't want the other hand to hurt. I need one good hand today. I gotta do stuff.
Ready?
No, don't wind up. God, this is getting worse and worse.
Really throw your hips into it, Kelly. You know what?
What?
If you run and run into a wall and fall over, it hurts a lot. If you run through the wall, it hurts slightly less.
Oh, yeah.
And the wall takes the brunt of it.
Is that right?
All right, let's get it done.
Okay. And I owe it all to you. Romantic.
Building out the interior of a sailboat comes with a ton of challenges. One of those being the fact that doorways and entry points are rather small. So you're not carrying full sheets of plywood in through a front door. It's really difficult to plan out for big pieces. One of those would be this. This is our bed platform. We've got this side butt jointed because we couldn't get both these pieces through any of the doorways. That's a challenge, but I mean, it's easily overcome. You cut it up, you put it back together where it's gonna be. But that means this can never leave this room. But now we gotta make this pretty and get it ready to paint. And there's two sides to this sucker. This side and this side. And here's where another challenge comes in you don't think of. That's the ceiling. This is the piece. I will need to find a way to hold it up so I can peel that peel ply off this side, fair it, sand it flat, and put a coat of paint on it. just some of the joys of building inside a boat. So I was able to use a little notch in the back and this screw to put it reliably, I think, up in the air. Reliably enough that we can do what we need to do. So you talk about the hardships, but one of the most satisfying things, on par with like bubble wrap and stuff, is peeling peel ply off once it's done. Now, to make this pretty, to make it sandable, to make it easy, we'll coat this in a fairing compound. And what is fairing compound? That's epoxy that has stuff in it that makes it easy to sand. Let's pause for a moment. I've been told that I say the word epoxy a lot in these videos, and that's probably very true. This boat is made of fiberglass, which means epoxy resin or polyester resin or some sort of resin is holding this entire boat together. I will try to limit the number of times that I spout off the word epoxy, but it's probably going to leave my mouth. I'll probably say epoxy a lot because epoxy is everywhere and epoxy is part of this process. I'm covered in epoxy, I have it in my hair, and I'm pretty sure I can't quite open this eye all the way because of epoxy. So I'm going to mix up a batch, we'll skim coat this side, and then wait for that to dry, and then we'll clean it all up at the same time. And then we'll be able to let that cure and lay it down, and then we'll do the same thing to the back side. These are the type of projects that are like baking cookies. You know, you put a thing of cookies in the oven, you go do something else, you take them out, and you put another thing of cookies in the oven. It's easier just to kind of do this while you're doing other work.
Meanwhile, I spent like 6 hours that day sanding and working on my tanning game. We spend a lot of quality time sanding and waiting for paint to dry.
When it comes to fairing, you have two options. You can buy a prefabricated product that you just kind of mix together and slap it on, and then you're done. Or you can take traditional epoxy and put an additive in there. Most of the time, it's the same stuff that's in the prefab product. And then mix it up by hand and use that. Really, it's kind of a wash cost-wise, so it's more a question of how much control do you want? How much additive do you want? Do you want to make sure that you're dictating that, or do you want someone in a factory who's already calibrated it to dictate that? Here is what I've used for the most part as far as prefab goes. This is Total Boat two-part fairing compound. Largely, I'm pretty happy with this stuff. It's super easy. It's mix this yellow stuff with this blue stuff in equal ratios and get green, and once it's nice and green, you spread it on, and then it sands easily. There is one thing that I'll put on the screen here because I forget what it's called, but basically what happens is when you spreading the product on, it kind of rolls up and causes problems behind where you're spreading, and it doesn't stay where you're putting it. It does that a little bit, so I'm not super happy about it. I think we could do better. The other thing I've been using is this. This is just a microbloon additive for West Systems 105 and whatever hardener you're using. Basically, this is when you get the control, and the product that you get when this is done is less thick than the Total Boat. And it's a little bit harder to sand, but you don't have as much of it on there, so there's less sanding to do, if that makes sense. Pinholing is another problem that you can get, where basically little air bubbles get trapped, so then when you sand it, you got a bunch of little pinholes in your finish. Both of these do pretty well with that. The new stuff I got is this over here. This is a company based in right up the road from us in Washington. It is out of, wait, let me see, Lacey, Washington. I'm kind of rooting for these guys because of that. This is their QuikFair. This one is a little different because you use two parts for this to every one part of this, which is a little harder to eyeball. But this is supposed to be a micro balloon based fairing compound, which is the same stuff this is. These are micro balloons. Theoretically, this is supposed to not do that tailing thing where it flips itself back up. And it's supposed to be a very consistent product that is a good all-around fairing compound. So we're going to give this a shot today and see how we like it. Let's mix up a batch and give it a go. Mix up a batch to put on the underside of the bed platform. So we'll grab, we'll say that much. Now I need one part of this, so how's that look? 2-1? Let's give it a mix.
You ready to have some fun? Let's do it.
One bummer about this is one being white and the other being colored means you're just going to have a slightly less pigmented version of the color as the final results. So you're basically just trying to get rid of streaks. But I like the idea of yellow and blue and green, so we'll give the edge to total boat so far. On the flip side, this seems a lot less thick. So that is actually a positive in my opinion, because it definitely doesn't feel like it would drip or sag. All right, nice consistent color. I think our ratio is pretty good. That was surprisingly easy to mix. We'll go up on the boat and apply it. Wiped it all down with some acetone, knocked down all the high spots before I started. Give this a shot. Sometimes you'll get a product that'll start hardening on you. This still seems nice and pliable, but it's supposed to be sandable within 3 hours. I always feel like when I'm done fairing that I nailed it and it'll be easy. Then I come back and sand it and almost always have to do a second pass of the product. But that's okay. To be expected. There. I'm gonna call that good.
Remember that cookie analogy from a few minutes ago? Seems like there's always a small sanding project to do while that fairing cookie bakes.
Well, we know the System 3 stuff went on well, but let's see about the stuff we want to come off. Overall, this acts a lot like the other fairing compounds that I've used. Surprise, surprise. I was right in that we're going to have to put one more little skim coat on everything just to get it nice and smooth, but I think one more will be great. I flipped it up, you can probably tell that I had to go the other way. This is a much better side because I can get at the top and the bottom without anything obstructing it. Quick update on the System 3 product, the fairing compound. It works pretty well. I wish it sanded a little quicker, but it definitely gives you a nice finish and nice and smooth. You can see up here that some of the tape has come through, but overall, all is smooth, and I think that should give us a nice finish once we paint.
I'm gonna need one of those and one of these. So this morning, I've been running around trying to gather supplies for today's activities, and right now, I'm at the Home Depot. This is the third Home Depot I've been to today. Apparently, there is a shortage of Rust-Oleum products available, and it's all due to COVID. That's what I've been told. So, that's interesting. Well, I struck out at Home Depot again, so hopefully Lowe's will be the hero today. Yay, Lowe's wins! I got four of these guys. That was the only option. I mean, I could have got more or less, I guess. I'm glad I found it. That was quite an adventure this morning. Anyway, back to work. Look at all this exciting stuff. It only took an hour and a half to accumulate. But wait, first we must prep. Moving down into the aft cabin, it's a little dusty and there's some extra tools and things. But look at that, that looks pretty great. Yep, hopefully by the end of this weekend, this will look a lot different. Hey Alexa, add sponges to shopping list.
Welcome to the kill room.
This is quite a setup.
Yeah, I got this idea from watching cabinet finishers do their thing.
That's not what I thought you were gonna say.
You take each piece of wood, you drill a small hole in a discrete spot, screw in one of these, and then you hang it. So when you spray it, no one touches it, and you can just kind of go like, boop. And it should be nice, even, and beautiful.
Cool.
And then it'll transform that room. I'm looking forward to it because, you know, those like big visual jumps. This is going to be one of them where it's like ugly and there's green and there's pink and there's red and then there's fiberglass yellow and all this nasty color. And then it's just going to be like, oh. Zone, Kelly.
I know, it's dangerous. But I have to get the footage.
For the channel! Alright, last chance, Kelly. Did you get a good before in here? So I'm about to transform it.
You're so cute.
I'm smiling, can you tell?
I can, because you smize. Can you smile with your eyes? Firebanks.
I'm so ready for this macaroon cabinet to go away.
That's about to happen.
Yeah.
Hand me my gun. Here I go.
Whoa. Shit.
I think we are ready now. We have everything all primed and prepped, wiped down, taped off. There's our mac and cheese closet, no longer so cheesy.
Now time for the last piece, the final coat on our butt-jointed bed platform. And maybe one final scrub.
Take smoldering coals seriously or you'll catch your shot back on fire. I don't see any open flames, so I think we're okay. Oh, that's what you teach your kids.
All right, move on. Nothing to see here. Please disperse. Nothing to see here. Please.
You may want to check in with us next week for the full story. In case you're new to our channel and you're wondering what this looked like before, here it is. This is the aft cabin in the state we bought it. Then we gutted the rest and started framing. Not only do we have a floor we can walk on now, but we also have plenty of stowage and an aesthetic and design we really love. We're just a few projects out from being complete. Hey you, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed what you saw and you want to keep following along, become a subscriber. Just hit that subscribe button below.
Quick update on the System 3 fairing compound. That's attractive. Looks like I have a drug problem.